You know what it is? Manifest your destiny.
I love that.
Go after what you want, people.
I love you.
Listening.
44 years,
yeah.
By the way. Did you think when you were, I think you were 20, weren't you?
I was
when you
19.
Did, 19.
Yeah.
Did you think it would last this long, the franchise?
Oh, I didn't think anything. Who thinks at 19?
You just take the, take the opportunity.
Take the opportunity. It was 17 days. I mean, it was 2.5 weeks. And then it was over.
Is that it?
And then it came out. And then, you know, it dribbled out. It took a while for it to become something. And I didn't get any work after it. It wasn't like it, like today, you know, like a box. Like it just grew. It was slow growing like a bacteria.
Like a weed.
Like a weed. And it just, it overtook everything at that point.
But it's crazy, isn't it?
I know.
Why do you think it is that people, like myself, to be honest, like it's become, I feel like it's becoming more popular now than it's ever been. It keeps
so
growing.
Much more popular. It was after the 2018 movie.
Yeah.
The 2018 movie popped the cork. You know, it just unleashed a renewal love of Laurie Strode.
Yeah.
It was a 40th anniversary movie. It coincided with the women's movement and the Me Too and Time's Up. And here was Laurie Strode, the ultimate Me Too-er, saying, no more.
Yeah.
I am owning my power. And then we made a movie about mob violence, which we made 2 years before the big social uprising of people saying the system is broken. I'm going to take back the power.
Yeah.
Which we saw in America particularly. And now it's a movie about that we're all monsters. It's not just Michael Myers.
Well, this is really interesting because I saw, sorry, I feel like a stalker, but I've looked at your Twitter, obviously, because I follow you.
Apparently and, you do.
And you did an interview and you said in the interview, you got asked, who do you hate the most? Or something along those lines. Actually, I have it written down there somewhere. And you gave a really lovely answer. Okay. And you said, hurt people.
Yeah.
So you didn't say a name or anything. And I thought that was so honest and so real. Do you think there's a tiny bit of that that's in everybody, and specifically actually also in the town?
Well, it is in everybody because you've already brought up the portal for hatred, which is Twitter.
Oh yeah.
You have brought up the very thing that you see has seeded now this opportunity for everyone to hate,
to voice an opinion.
And it's very rarely love.
Yeah.
And it's very rarely... Remember that the internet was originally constructed as a way to communicate, to connect, to share ideas, share images, share movies, share things, share ideas, and connect with people.
And innovate.
I could connect to you. I could be in Santa Monica. You could be here. You're how old?
30.
Right. I'm 64, my Beatles birthday
you
this year.
You look great.
Thank you. But my point is, we could connect. We could be connected through something. And what the movie posits as an idea is that we are all monsters because of the way we victim shame.
Yeah.
Look at what happens. Look at how that level of violence infects a town and what it does to the townspeople against the girl who was a victim.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. But I think that's so cleverly done.
But it's a social statement.
Yeah.
And so it's a Trojan horse buried in the middle of a horror film, which is, what are we doing as a society?
Mm.
And it bears conversation. And so I'm excited that the movie has that at the center of a blood and guts horror film.
How brilliant is that? That last sentence you just said, that's at the center of a blood and guts horror film. And look, how do you want, because we're at the end now, Halloween ends, how do you want people to feel when they leave that theatre?
That's a great... I've never heard that question been posed like
yes!
that.
Come on!
Seriously. I've heard a lot about how do I feel about it. No, like, how do I feel ending it all? It's all about me. I want them to feel that the story is complete.
Mm.
That there is a complete story told. Heartbreaking those stories can be. There is a conclusion to this story, and it's not a happy ending for anybody in the sense of there's no celebration in the ending of it. There's a feeling that comes from it that is makes us all think a lot about what we've all done to each other.
Wow.
And It's exciting for people. I think they will be surprised. I think some people will be angry.
I'm going to be sad.
Some people will be sad.
Well, I don't want it to finish, but we've grown with you.
I understand. And that's what I'm saying, is that there's all sorts of feeling, or as you young people say, is this a young person's radio station?
I'd like to say so, yeah. What's an everybody station?
Oh, you're an everybody station. Well, that should be their logo, by the way.
Yeah. I'm
we're an everybody
logos.
Station. But I would say you're going to feel all the feels.
Oh,
that there's a lot of feels here. And there's going to be rage, anger, joy, disappointment, all the feels, which is life.
And how does Laurie feel? Does she feel alone? She's trying to move on in this one, isn't she?
Well,
she's no longer trying to...
We see, you know, the thing about what's a miracle about the movie is that at the beginning of the movie, it's 4 years after the last movie.
Mm-hmm.
Her daughter was killed 4 years ago.
Yeah.
Many people in the town were killed. And... you know, we are meeting her at a very vulnerable moment. She has had some help. She's had some mental health help, grief counseling,
yeah.
crisis counseling. And she is trying to move on with her life. And there's a moment in the movie where we shot a scene and I went back to my trailer for lunch. And I was sitting in my trailer and my face hurt. And I couldn't feel, like I couldn't figure out why, I wondered if I gotten bitten, like yeah. stung by a bee or something. And then I looked in the mirror and I realized it's because I had been smiling in the scene.
Your cheeks hurt.
And my cheeks hurt. And I realized that I don't think I remember Laurie Strode ever smiling.
Wow.
And so there was that moment. There are those moments in the movie where for a second you feel like, oh, maybe everything's going to be okay. And maybe Laurie's going to actually have a life that was ripped away from her
yeah.
as the victim of this horrific crime when she was 17. And then, you know, everything collapses into a, you know, a cacophony of chaos. But for a brief moment, there's a real glimmer of hope. And I cling to that for her because that sweet girl has not had a lot of that.
Well, I've got to say, I cling to you. Not in a weird way.
Hey, now.
I'll ask you a question.
Yeah.
Did you see a photo of your husband?
I did.
And you said, I'm going to marry him.
I did, and married him.
How does that even
Four
work?
4 months later.
How does that work?
4 months, 5 months later. You know what it is? Manifest your destiny.
I love that.
Go after what you want, people.
I love you.
Listening. Go after what you want. And go watch Halloween Ends.
Yeah.